In other news, October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and a new study shows that breastfeeding could lessen your risk for breast cancer. Breastfeeding speeds up the production of healthy cells, and it sends in these specialized immune cells, and that lessens your chances of developing cancer, and the benefits continue for up to 50 years after having your children. Here to discuss is Fox News medical contributor, Dr. Nicole Saphier. Dr. Saphier, you deal with this all the time. You talk to women who are facing breast cancer and how to treat them. You're saving so many lives. This is incredible news, and what an encouragement for women to breastfeed.
Well, good morning, Ainsley. And yes, it has been well documented that breastfeeding and the longer you breastfeed decreases your risk of breast cancer. This has been confirmed over and over again by large meta-analysis studies all across the world. But there is a new study looking at exactly why this happens. So while we know there's a risk, we don't actually know the science behind why this happens. This study out of Australia, published in Nature, what they did was they looked at humans and then they also used some mouse models to help with their conclusions. They looked at healthy breast tissue and unhealthy breast tissue, some with cancer. And what they found was women who breastfed, they had high level of T cells in their breast tissue, T cells being those anti-tumor cells. They also help fight viruses and other things. And these T cells, when they started using the mouse modeling and then they actually looked at the breast tissue with cancer in it, they found that these T cells helped not only prevent the cancer from forming in the first place, but in women who had triple negative breast cancer, which is the most aggressive form of breast cancer, these T cells may have helped reduce the tumor size and help the women survive the breast cancer because they had better survivability the higher the T cells they had. So they believe that all of the changes in the breast from pregnancy, but also from lactation, and then the post-lactation involution when the body goes back to normal, with this high cell turnover, with the old cells going out, the new cells coming in, all of this may decrease the risk of breast cancer, and if breast cancer does form, can actually help fight breast cancer. Because as you pointed out in the introduction, these T cells are lasting in the woman's body for 50 years after breastfeeding. So imagine breastfeeding your babies and decades later, because you did that, that may actually help you survive breast cancer.
I know not all women can do that. A lot of people have problems with breastfeeding, but if you can, this is another reason why it's beneficial. In 2025, almost 317,000 new cases of breast cancer and 42,000 estimated deaths. What do you think the reason is? Is it environmental? Is it something that we're putting in our bodies?
Well, Ainsley, it's a great question. And the reality is we are seeing more women with breast cancer. And it's not just because we're screening and we're diagnosing more. The reality is we are seeing more breast cancer in younger people. We're also seeing more lung cancer, more colon cancer. So why is that? Well, yes, being a woman, getting older, those are some of our highest risk factors. Genetic mutations in our DNA also are causing this, but it's also the exposure in the environment. We see chemicals, we are seeing microplastics and everything from the air we breathe to the lotions that we put on our skin to the makeups. These all have some of those forever chemicals in it. And we know that these forever chemicals can disrupt our DNA and they can cause cancer to form. So unless you're going to live in a bubble, there's no way to avoid all of these harmful chemicals. The best we can do is to live our healthiest life, make sure that we are getting our cancer screening. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So if you haven't gotten your mammogram, I highly recommend it. But at the end of the day, you can talk to your doctor. There are some things that we can do to reduce our risk of cancer, and breastfeeding is one of them.
Okay. Dr. Saphier, some great news when it comes to AI. There are some companies where they're using their algorithms not only to detect breast cancer, but also to determine who's at risk before it's even noticeable to the visual eye, to your doctor. Your doctor might not see the signs, but AI is picking up on this.
Yeah, so this is really interesting. Ainsley, when I'm not here with you, you know, I am in the hospital, I'm looking at images of the breasts, of the entire body, and I'm trying to find subtle abnormalities that may indicate cancer is there or it's developing. And if I find it, then I biopsy it. For the last 5 to 10 years, I've already been using a basic level of AI to help me pick up on those subtleties, and that has increased our cancer diagnostic rate anywhere from 10 to 20%. Now, this next generation of AI, not only do they want to help us find the cancer, but they're going to want to help us predict who is going to develop that cancer. Because the people who are in the highest risk category of developing cancer, we can change their screening regimen, possibly add contrast-enhanced mammogram, MRIs, or we even may consider giving them a medication to reduce the risk of that cancer forming in the first place. Right now, we use what's called risk calculators. We look at essentially their risk of developing cancer based on their family history, based on some other things, their age. But this next generation AI, they want to take the mammogram image or the lung image from a CT scan. They actually want to take images of the body, combine that with those risk calculators, and try and give us who's going to develop this cancer. And while we're pretty good right now with identifying up to 60% of people who are in that high-risk category, this next generation AI is increasing that to 70%. 60% to 70%, maybe that doesn't sound like a big deal to you, but we're talking thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of women who are potentially high risk for developing these cancers. But it's not just breast cancer. They're doing this for lung cancer and other cancers as well. Very important because early detection matters.
Absolutely. Dr. Saphier, thank you so much.
I'm Steve Ducey.
I'm Brian Kilmeade.
And I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis.